mankind back to God.
Yes, sir.
And the Bible says, greater love has no man than this, that they lay down their life for a friend.
Yeah.
And Jesus said, I no longer call you servants, but I call you friend. And he loved us so much that he gave all that he had to give. He gave his life a ransom for the rents. Because the conditions called for a lamb to be offered without spot or wrinkle. Can I get a witness here today? Yes, in the past they used bulls and goats. They used lambs and other animals. But this sacrifice would be different. This sacrifice was a man named Jesus. And he was called the Lamb of God, which takes away the sin of the world. Well, this Lamb was without spot or wrinkle. Those were the conditions of the ransom. And James said he was tempted in all points, but yet he did not see.
Yeah.
That's why he was a lamb without spot or a wrinkle. Yeah. You need to know sin leaves blemishes. Yeah. Sin leaves a mark in your life.
Yeah.
But Jesus didn't sin, so therefore he had no spots or wrinkles.
Yeah.
He condemned sin in the flesh.
Yeah.
Because see, we were designed to be able to abolish those acts of the flesh. Jesus came to destroy the works of the flesh, not to be destroyed by them. And now if you and I are following Jesus, then we can do the same thing. We can be those who are victorious and not be destroyed by the works of the flesh. But we can destroy the works of the flesh through our service to God. Can you witness in here? Yes. He had to pour out his life. His blood had to be poured out as a ransom for the race. And in order for that to happen, his life had to be given in exchange for our redemption. He ransomed his life for the race. They nailed his hands to an old running cross. They put rivets in his feet. They hung him high and stretched him wide. They put a crown of thorns upon his brow. He hung there from the sixth to the ninth hour. He was hung between two thieves. One said, you saved others. Why don't you save yourself and save us too? And then the other thief railed on him. He said, don't you even fear God. He said, we've done evil, but this man has done nothing wrong. And he turned to Jesus and said, Lord, when you enter into your kingdom, please remember me. And Jesus turned to the dying thief. He didn't get baptized. They didn't slay him in the spirit. But Jesus said to him, today thou shalt be with me in paradise. He told John, John, behold your mother, because his mother came to the cross, weeping along with the other women. And he told Mary, Mary, behold your son. And John took Mary home to care for her from that day forward. And then Jesus, my Savior and your Lord, he cried out with a loud voice, it's finished. Father, into my hands I commit my spirit. He died, yes he did, he died. And the song.
I don't know.
he paid. You don't have to pay. We told him at 7 o'clock this morning, just like you're going to dinner, pick your favorite restaurant. My wife likes Red Lobster. Yeah, that's just it's me too. Yes, Lord. You don't have the lobster special. You're going to splurge tonight. But you know you really ain't splurging. Because many of us is robbing Peter to pay Paul. And while you eat that meal, you thinking of where that money coming from. Okay, this is going to be part of the light bill. The garbage ain't going to get the whole thing. Yeah, the phone, I can pay a $5 late fee and pay that 3 weeks later. But I can eat this steak and lobster right now. And you happen to see Brother Tom Thomas walk through the door. He done walked in and said, "Hey man, I've been wanting to bless you. Give me your check." And he takes your bill. Say, "Don't worry about that guy." Now most of y'all, that lobster gonna start tasting a whole lot better. That steak gonna get a little bit more tender. So somebody else paid for it. You know how it is when you got the little gift card and you go and eat, you walk in with cop, yeah. Right? Cop, yeah. When you gotta pay for it, you're like, you don't even want to go, you ain't gonna look at the price, you get off. But you're thinking of where that thing come from. But when somebody else pays for it, oh, it makes you feel good. That's what happened when Jesus paid for our sins. Because he paid for it. You don't have to pay for it. You can live this life and know that even if you mess up, it's still paid for. You paid your car and you reckon it's paid for. Hope you got full coverage. Jesus is our full coverage. It can be fully restored. Nothing comes out of your pocket. You've been paid for. It was a ransom for the race. He did what nobody else could do. If there was no resurrection, we wouldn't have the victory that we have.